dear friends, welcome to Darshana YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss a couple of questions from the chapter photosynthesis. Okay, first question: minimum number of cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation required for the production of one molecule of glucose in C3 plants. Okay, so this is a combination of two concepts, first one from the light reaction and second from the dark reaction. Okay, so we know we require in C3 plants for the production of one molecule of glucose, we require 18 ATP and we require 12 NADPH2. Okay, 12 NADPH2. Now, from one cyclic photophosphorylation, okay, from one cyclic photophosphorylation, we will get 1 ATP. Okay, and from one cyclic, non-cyclic photophosphorylation, we will get what? 1 ATP, and also we will get 1 NADPH2. Okay, so the question is that the minimum number of cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation required. Okay, so total we require 12 NADPH2. So NADPH2 we are getting only from where? The non-cyclic. So it should undergo 12 cycles. Okay, so 12 cycles, that is 12 non-cyclic photophosphorylation should takes place to get how many NADH2? 12 NADH2. Okay, now when we get this 12 NADH2, along with this, we are also getting what? We are also getting 12 ATP. Okay, so totally we need 12 NADH2 and 18 ATP. Okay, so this thing, that means 12 NADH2 and 12 ATP we will get from non-cyclic. Okay, so the rest of the things we can take from cyclic. Okay, so from cyclic we only get what? ATP. That means rest of the 6 ATP can be taken from cyclic. Okay, for the 6 ATP we require how many cycles? Six cycles. Okay, 6 cycles. That means 6 cyclic photophosphorylation and 12 non-cyclic photophosphorylation will result in the formation of what? 12 NADPH2 and 18 ATP. Okay, so what is the option from here? That is 6 cyclic and 12 non-cyclic. Okay, now coming to the next question. In the Z scheme of photophosphorylation, that means non-cyclic photophosphorylation, which one of the following act as a strong oxidant and a weak oxidant? Okay, so which one of the following molecule is acting as a strong oxidant and a weak oxidant? Okay, see, you can see here, when cyclic photo, non-cyclic photophosphorylation, we call it as Z scheme. Why? Because the arrangement of electron carriers on the basis of their increasing redox potential scale. Okay, now what is redox potential? The ability of a chemical species to absorb, to take the affinity shown to absorb the electrons. Okay, so here you can see the P6AT molecules in non-cyclic photophosphorylation, P6AT molecules which is placed, you can see in the redox potential scale, they are placed in the highly positive region, that means up to the between 2 or 3. And you can see here, they are having a high electron potential, that means high redox potential. They have a higher affinity to take electrons, so that they will always tends to take some electrons from anywhere. So they will get some water. Okay, they will photolyze water and take these electrons. Okay, and so that we can say that the P6AT act as a strong oxidant. Okay, P6AT is having a very positive value. They will act as a strong oxidant. Okay, at the same time, when they get these electrons and when they get some energy from the red light, they come to an excited state. Okay, when they move to an excited state, when P6AT move to an excited state, you can see here, they will come to a point, that means just between 0 and negative 0.5. That means they are acting as a weak reductant. When it move up, when it became more negative value, we can say that it is becoming a strong reductant. But it is not a strong reductant, but it is a weak reductant. That means it is lying just above the, or just below the 0. That means between negative 0.5 and 0. Okay. Now what will happen? When they become a weak reductant, It has a tendency to release electrons. That electrons will be released to the various components of the electron transport chain. And finally, it reaches to that's a P700. Okay, now we can see the position of P700. Where is P700 position? P700 is positioned between P680. That means excited P680 and non-excited P680. That means P680 here, it is positioned as a strong oxidant. So in between, you can see that this is a weak oxidant. P700 acts as a weak oxidant. Thereafter, what will happen? The electrons will reach the P700. They will also absorb light from far red region. Okay. Thereafter, they also get into an excited stage. P700 also get into an excited stage. Okay. You can see here P700 move to the excited stage. Now see the position of P700. P700 is much more higher negative compared to all other compounds. That means they are forming strong reductant. They are forming strong reductant, which is placed about 1.5, negative 1.5, or you can say negative 2. Okay. That means here you can say that excited P70 act as strong reductant. And non-excited P70 act as what? They act as a weak reductant. And the normal, that means excited P680. Excited P680 act as weak reductant. And non-excited P680 act as strong reductant. Okay, now coming back to question. You can see in the Z scheme of photophosphorylation, which one of the following act as strong oxidant and weak oxidant? Strong oxidant and weak oxidant. Which can act as strong oxidant and weak oxidant. Here is the strong oxidant, here is the weak oxidant. That means P680 is the strong oxidant and P700 is the weak oxidant. Okay. P680 is the strong oxidant and P700 is the weak oxidant. Okay. So these are the two questions that we discussed today. Hope you understand the concept. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please comment on the comment box. Okay, feel free to ask your doubt. Okay, along with that, please subscribe our channel. Thank you.